Hi, I'm Mike Madewell from the Technical Support Department. And in this section, we'll be discussing spray sprinkler maintenance and installation. We'll be covering how to flush a sprinkler, adjust the arc, adjust the radius, clean the filter, and install a check valve. When you first install a sprinkler, there is usually a lot of debris that gets trapped inside the pipe. This debris makes its way into the sprinkler when the water is turned on. To prevent clogging of the sprinkler, it is recommended that you flush the sprinkler with the flush cap that comes pre-installed from the factory. To flush the sprinkler, turn the valve on for a few seconds just to allow all the debris to exit the sprinkler in the pipe. This job can be made easier by using a Hunter Roam remote. Once the sprinkler is clean, you can install the nozzle. To install the nozzle, pull the riser and hold it up with one hand. Unthread the flush cap, being careful not to release the riser. Drop the filter in place, and then thread on the nozzle. To make adjustments to a spray sprinkler, it is preferred that the sprinkler is on so that you can see the actual adjustment. While the sprinkler is watering, look at the right side and see if it is aligned. If it is not, then you will need to align it by turning the entire riser to the correct position, as this is the fixed side of the arc. While turning the riser, you will hear a noise. This is totally normal, as the sprinkler has a ratcheting system that allows you to make this adjustment. To adjust the left arc, you need to grab the edge of the nozzle and turn it clockwise to reduce the arc, or counterclockwise to increase it. Another adjustment you can make is the radius, in other words, how far the water will throw. To adjust the radius, use a flathead screwdriver to turn the screw in the middle of the nozzle. If you need to reduce the radius, turn the screw clockwise. If you need to reach a little farther, turn it the opposite direction or counterclockwise. If this radius adjustment is not enough for your needs, then you will need to choose a different nozzle size. Now your sprinkler should be ready to operate. However, sometimes the filter underneath the nozzle may get clogged with sediment from the water. This will result in a diminished flow of the water. To clean the filter, pull the riser up and hold it with one hand. With your other hand, unthread the nozzle and pull the filter out. You may want to turn the valve on for a couple of seconds just to flush the line in the sprinkler. Make sure to clean the filter and verify that it is still in good condition. If it is, put it back in place. If you notice that water continues to drain after the zone has been shut down, then you may have a low head drainage problem. This can be easily solved by installing a check valve. A check valve for sprinklers can be ordered from your local distributor with part number 437400. To install a check valve, remove the dirt around the sprinkler so that you can unthread the body cap. Start unthreading the body cap, making sure not to unthread the body from the fitting below. Once you have pulled the riser out, install the check valve at the bottom of the riser. Install the sprinkler back into the body and make sure it is properly aligned. So these were just a few tips to help you maintain your Hunter spray sprinkler system. If you need additional help, consult Hunter Industries' website for more resources.